Let me just point something out. Really smart play coming in from Seven Seas as well, as you mentioned. I'm going to hold on to my point because it looks like Zeus are unloading everything that they have on A1 Esports.
Look at Icy. He's just pushing in like a madman. He knows there's someone in the smoke. He knows there's a res taking place. The Sinister will fall. Dante, the res in the smoke. It won't happen. And in a heartbeat, A1 Esports will be wiped out from the server. Two teams bid us adieu pretty early here in the mid-game. Centers, the circle's favoring them. Magnet, a little bit of a mishap with the vehicle. That is unfortunate. As Mimo, 7C, rattling off a few bullets in the direction of 1952, who are towards a water treatment plant. And Dead Eyes, guys. F4! The nades! Bombardment coming in from Wolverine! He's gonna find one. They found two, and it is not looking good for Dead Eyes, guys. Here, they have one member surviving, as Wadu Sir will also meet a grave to the HE. And Shifu Sir won't, sorry, I do believe that's on top, won't survive for much longer either, leaving them with only one member left standing. What a wipe coming in from the side of F4.
And we just called it, you know, F4 were phenomenal in Miramar, and Khan, of course, is one of the best Renadiers out there, you know, basically opening up this little play for his team as Wolverine came in with nades of his own. But no, Utsarga is the last man standing, way out at the edge of the blue zone, and I guess Zeus do not have an idea, but snipe YT try to take a few shots. Oh. Unfortunately, not successfully.
Not successful, he gets knocked down, but... Oh my lord, Godless is spraying through the smoke! He's gonna find Praveen as well, and look at Abel pushing in, looking to confirm the kills, getting harassed by multiple players, and Zeus, they're unstoppable! Monster! And they're gonna wipe out the team T. Oh my lord!
Let me point something out again. This time, again, three members of Zeus went forward. Godless stays behind, out near the blue circle. That is the unexpected that they do. That is the thing that I love about them. And have a look at that. 9 kills to their names already. And they're not done yet, Play, because Kuni from High Voltage and his teammate are coming under heavy fire.
Oh, it's one of those games, isn't it? It's one of those games where Zeus just go rampaging and destroying every single one. Assassin is a great spot, though. And he's gonna pop out with the barrel. And he's going to find Icy looking to finish off the job. He's going to push in into the blue. He's kind of low here. And his teammates have managed to heal themselves. So suddenly, Abel has a lot of work to do. He's got to try and prevent High Voltage from pushing on up. He does have backup in the form of these other two teammates, but a distance away. Nades being tossed in, Abel deploying a smoke.
What works for Zeus is Godless and Zeol are covered from the team on the right of our screen, so they can actually focus all the way over here. They do have that little car for cover. And how about the circle right at the edge? So, you know, everyone is over there. F4 still in it. And Abel does the right thing to regroup with his teammates.
The thing is, right now for High Voltage, they're in a fantastic...
Now, again, Stalwart Flex, have a look outside the circle. And Zeus only are going to concentrate on them, which is the right call, because they do not want to be shot from behind.
And of course, this little ridge that Zeus have, and it is in the play zone, so they have so much to work with right now, but they do have to be wary of potential nade rolling down and taking them down. Baron, in the meantime, just unleashing on the Stalwart Flex. They are looking like they're in a rough spot, but Reviews replies back.
He does indeed, and of course, those long-distance shots are going to come in handy, as he still has that rock for cover in all that smoke. But right now, Zeus, they could end it with one grenade.
They could end it with one grenade, and there you go. One grenade is all that Zeol needs to take down Blade. And Stalwart Flex now left in a one-man squad. Reviews will fall to F4. F4 is going to strike on multiple teams. They're going to start finally opening up on all the teams around them. Look at their position.
Look at the position, but now look at HV's position as well. We did kind of talk about they have to worry about P and crew, but wait on a second. Seal are moving in. That is a little bit of a risky maneuver, as they are going to get caught from all angles, and this is not looking good for Seal Esports.
It's not looking good at all. They are bleeding out, and they're getting mowed down by F4. Zeke will fall. Wolverine on a bit of a dominant spree.
Look at your screen right now. High Voltage is moving further up north, and now they are going to give F4 a run for their money.
It's not looking good at all for Seal, though. They're down to just Wally, I believe, is still up and standing. But don't forget, Zeus are still in contention. Godless and Abel. Zeol has been knocked down, and they're taking his duel right now against High Voltage. Godless, in the meantime, getting knocked down as well. So Abel needs to make up his mind. Does he go for the rest, or does he try and stay alive? Because both, all three members are right now outside of the play zone. Down to the final three. Team Seal getting eliminated, and High Voltage, all three still alive. F for all three still alive. And for Zeus, it just might be Abel here.
It just might be Abley, and it does kind of look like Godless and Zeol are going to be bleeding out. It's going to be that slow and painful death for them. But right now, it looks like Waltrux and Wolverine have an idea that someone is behind them. Have a look at Khan's position. He's making sure he has that left flank covered, if Assassin pops his head out, he might shoot at Waltrux. Waltrux might bait him out, but Assassin is going to put a few bullets in his head. And there you go. Abley going in for the revives again. You cannot let Zeus pick their teammates up, because one man is enough, but three, oh my goodness.
And what's happening right now is Khan has spotted out High Voltage, High Voltage announcing their presence. That's going to give Zeus a little bit of time to work with.
Check out those cars over there on the right side of the wall. That is going to give Khan even a lot more cover, but Ozzy moves in. Voltrox and Wolf, we are now going to be concerned, but now Khan can actually be in a position to lay down some lead. Oh. But I think that is not going to happen.
Molotov exchange. Ozzy's burning alive. He's burning alive. He's got a drop and roll. I love the covering fire provided by Kuni and Assassin when Ozzy pushed on in. And while all this commotion is taking place between F4 and High Voltage, Zeus have pushed into the play zone.
They are revamping themselves up. They are getting ready for their second wind as Godless is going to have... He has an idea someone is going to be behind the tractor, but does he know who it is? At this point, I'm pretty sure they don't really care about that. Ozzy is going to be rained on by grenades, almost getting knocked off his feet. One more would have done the job.
The blue is pushing in, and Zeus Esports, they are still outside of the play zone. They need to make a move, but it's open terrain, as we do have a hailstorm of grenades back and forth between F4 and High Voltage.
I mean, it's just amazing, and Abley with that AWM, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's
that
go.
Airdrop coming in handy. Khan's position was exposed, and now Khan is going to be bleeding on his knees, which means High Voltage can move in on F4's position, and Zeus are looking amazing.
Ready, willing, and able are Zeus right now as they push into the play zone. The AWM getting picked up in that final drop as well. Godless has jumped on in, and now F4 are getting harassed by multiple teams. Godless with a jumping spray, not able quite landed as Voltus will take him down, but Voltus in return getting knocked on by Aussie, helping out Zeus Esports. F4 down, to, I do believe, now to just one man. It's Wolverine. I really hope his claws are sharp and ready to go here, because he's in a 1v3v3, taking a bit of damage from the nade. He's hiding in the smoke. And now it's Zeus versus High Voltage and Wolverine trapped in between.
Let me tell you one thing. Godless almost had his opponent, but the Grotza's rate of fire is just phenomenal. And now Godless are going to get a little bit impatient. He needs to patch himself up, which he's going to do. Zeol has the right idea, making sure the right flank is secure, and Abley is going to be going in with him. They are trying to use that smoke to their advantage. However, you see this fence, that gap in the middle? You do not want to be on that side when your feet can be seen underneath.
Absolutely. And if you're up close, your feet are going to be seen, and you won't be able to spot anyone else out. So them playing up close here, and I like how High Voltage is playing a little bit more back so they can spot the feet out from the side of Zeus Esports as well.
They want to make sure they have those concrete walls to hide behind and those hay bales as well. So again, they are positioning themselves well. Now Kuni just might spot Abley. Expect a big AWM to go boom, and someone might just fall down.
We wanted this. We wanted the AWM action up close and personal here. And it looks like Abel, he's going to be the one who's going to be looking to deliver. He's got the ghillie suit as well. Does a camo. He knows where Ozzy is. He has an inkling where Kuni is as well. But no one knows where Wolverine is. He is still lying prone in the smoke.
He's been deploying smoke grenade after smoke grenade after smoke grenade. So potentially it is going to be a little bit injurious to his health later on. But right now it is definitely helping him out. Those arm shots are still going to keep going.
I do worry for Wolverine's lungs at this point in time. The amount of smoke this guy's inhaling, it's not healthy at all. Oh, look, it's Zeol sneaking in from behind. You called it, and he delivers. And that is going to be the knock. And now it's a 3v2. Ozzy, I believe, hasn't spotted out. Zeol is being such a thorn. He is just riddling them with bullets. A second knock comes in, this time from Godless, and they're moving in from the kill. Abel, he knows there's another player nearby. The jumping shot comes in from Godless. Couple of finishes. They spot out Wolverine as well. The smoke's finally dissipated, and Zeus Esports, they came, they saw, they kicked ass.
Ladies and gentlemen, bow down to the gods, because Zeus Esports are back in business, winning the chicken dinner. And again, I love the fact that whenever the camera pans to them, game face on.
Another day
24/7.
Another day in the office.
Another day in the office, just like this dude to my right, who looks like he just came out of an office right now. But what a game. What a clinical finish. The tactical prowess on display was
finished from them. And F4 Wolverine, oh my lord, how many smokes this guy had in that moment.
He survived till the time. It just mattered a lot. Five kills coming up, 2 assists, 204 damage.
In towards fifth circle at least, but talk about top players. Well, we've got Sandesh chiming in from PN Crew as well, alongside, of course, Zeus Esports and F4 Wolverine.
5-5-5-5.
Get the match ranking coming in from this game. That is going to be showcasing Zeus Esports certainly getting those kills working in their favor. 29 points is what they walk away with. But Team F4 opening up those numbers finally.
So like or share, thok dijiye Mahakal ka. Tumhare like or share, thok dijiye. 5000 lote dik jana chahiye. Ye 4000 ke liye main yahan pe nahi khada hu. Pura saal mehnat karta hu aapke liye beta. Aisa nahi chalega, aisa nahi chalega. Like thok ki daba ke. Like thok ki. Yahan pe dekhiye.